Your PC ran into a problem and needs to restart. Any Windows user has seen this screen and read those words at least once in their life. Most of these users still have no clue what to do about it though. I've seen the infamous blue screen of death tons of times, and I'll show you 8 steps to fixing almost any blue screen. All you have to do is stick around. 3 important notes before we begin. First, the blue screen of death is essentially a stop error, which happens whenever Windows encounters an issue it can't fix without restarting. Second, keep in mind that no version of Windows is safe from BSoD. On Windows 10, blue screens are just as much of an issue as on Windows 7 and below. Lastly, in order to know how to fix blue screen of death, you need to know what caused it. That's where the error code that's always included in the blue screen is coming in so valuable. Always make sure you grab that bad boy. And don't forget, you can always leave a like and a subscribe for more informative IT-related content. All right, here goes the first reason for BSoD: hardware failure. If you've just added some new hardware, SSD drive, RAM sticks, even something like an external printer, the incompatibility could cause the blue screen of doom to appear. How do you fix that? Well, try removing the hardware you just installed and booting without it. If everything works, we've got ourselves a culprit. For some of the next troubleshooting moves I'm about to show you, you need to know how to boot your PC into safe mode. So first, you have to turn your PC off and then on again. While it's still booting, shut it down. Repeat twice more to enter WinRE, Windows Recovery Environment. In there, click Advanced Options. Then Troubleshoot, Advanced Options again, and then Startup Settings. Now restart, and once the system is rebooted, press F4 to enable safe mode. This might be very useful if you run into incompatible software, the second most common reason behind the blue screen of destruction. If you've just installed a new app and running it makes BSoD pop out, well, the reason's clear. But what if your software is in the auto load queue? And before you have a chance to load your Windows 10, blue screen of death already strikes. That's where the safe mode comes into play. Once you boot into safe mode, only the most essential software will load, allowing you to clean the malevolent apps from your PC. Sometimes, however, BSoD's caused by an unexpected flaw in hardware, some kind of failure in the memory of your PC, or even the motherboard itself. I usually use memory diagnostic tool to make sure I know what's going on, since it will give me insights into the state of my RAM. To open this tool while you're in safe mode, press the Windows key and R key simultaneously to open the Run dialog box. This is where you need to type mdsched.exe and press enter. Click on restart now and check for problems. Your PC will reboot and run a diagnostic test showing you if there are any memory issues. If you can see some significant problems in your RAM, there might be no other solution but to replace it. When the blue screen of disdain strikes, sometimes it's malware that's at fault. And I know there are various ways of dealing with viruses and such, so let me briefly discuss things I use. As far as antiviruses go, Bitdefender is one of my personal favorites. A good firewall, reliable real-time threat protection, and fast scans. Plus, it's been rated highly by folks at the AV Comparatives, so I have trust in this antivirus. Another great alternative is NordVPN. Its threat protection feature worked very well for me, detecting malware in downloaded files and warding off websites with potential malware risks. I use it a lot in conjunction with an antivirus for additional protection. So this is my personal combo versus all kinds of malware. You can take notes if you want. While malware is a possible cause behind the blue screen of despair, it can also be something fairly innocuous, like, I don't know, outdated drivers. It's rather easy to check. Just press Windows plus X to open the device manager. And if you see a yellow triangle anywhere, this means a possible driver issue. Right click on the problematic entry and click Update Driver, then choose Search Automatically and let Windows fix the blue screen for you. That said, what if a newer driver causes the blue screen of disappointment? Or a memory issue, or a failure in system files that you can't fix. That's when I use FFC Scan, which will go through all the protected system files and configurations, repairing them if required. Once again, Windows plus R to open the dialog box and type CMD to launch command prompt as an administrator, and type in SFC space /scan now. And don't forget to press enter. That's about it. Now the scan will slowly go on its way, fixing any issues it's encountered. But okay, now let's say you have tried everything to no avail. The blue screen of dismay just keeps being an issue, and at this point you're now completely out of options. Well, there are always last resorts, and the BSoD case is no different. You can do a system restore, rolling your system back to the latest clean state, where everything worked as intended. This state could be pretty far back in the past though. If you're feeling confident, there are steps you should take. Click Start, go to Search, and type System Restore. In the following menu, choose Open System Restore and proceed to confirm which date you're going to go back to. Afterwards, finalize the restore and get it going. That said, if you're going to lose too much with a restore and you're not sure if this will fix the issue anyway, there's one more method, even more last resort-ish than System Restore. It's a Windows reinstallation. Just back up the stuff you need, if you can do that between encountering the blue screen of dread. Finish by performing a clean system install. If this video was useful for you, please leave a like and subscribe. That would be a huge help for me. In conclusion, now you know some general cases and how to fix blue screen of death. To avoid future issues with the merciless blue screen of death, Windows 10 users like you and me need to take good care of their hardware and software and keep all important systems in their PC up to date. And for those using earlier versions, I really recommend upgrading. In my experience, older Windows installments are more susceptible to blue screen of death. Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. And make sure to ask if you have any questions left.